No mystery. No mystery today. I'm going to tell you exactly who I'm talking about today. I'm talking about you. How's that sound? This is as close as I can get to my microphone. Still be doing things the way I kind of want to do them. I had, and I'm not making this up, it was a comment suggestion by one of my viewers about discussing lucid dreams. And I did have a very lucid dream last night. I don't know if he influenced it or I just ate too much Chinese or my sushi didn't agree with me. But I had a tremendous lucid dream last night. And it was, it wasn't troubling at all. And it wasn't sad or anything like that. Hang on, my computer's really been acting up lately. I like to keep an eye on my recording. So this is a lot different. This is more like a DJ Mad Mike video coming at you from ASMR television. And just something different. I just want to get in here and talk to you. And I want to discuss something. It was really weird. I just want to tell you something. And don't worry. I have a box of tingles for everybody. I'm going to steal something from my friend Laura Minx. Let's see if everybody likes it when I do it. Okay. Tingles, 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 tingles. Tingles, 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 tingles. I don't know. I saw my friend Minxie in a video by these new artists. They were nice enough to mention Big Baby. And it's Fantasy ASMR, but they have a different name. But I'll put them in the description below. They're, a husband and wife team. Of course, I don't know them that well because I have trouble getting to know people. I don't probably ask the right questions. But they seem very nice. They're trying really hard to fit in and get to know everyone. And they at least deserve to be acknowledged for the fact that they took the trouble to make a unbelievably fantastic video with Laura Minx, 1, 2, 3. It was exceptional. Laura was spot on. I don't know what possessed her, but it was, I don't know if it was her idea or their idea, but it was pure genius. And, it was really good. She took you around the house and showed you how everyday items could be used in an ASMR video to bring peace and tranquility to other people and viewers. It was amazing. When I say amazing, it was thoughtful. You know, she actually had a cameraman and she went around the house and she went to a lot of effort to do it. And it shows, you know, she's definitely the spokesperson for the ASMR community. She is the ambassador, if you will, of goodwill, bridging the ASMR community to the normal communities out there. I'm talking about Laura Minx, 1, 2, 3, because she takes the time to explain things and bring people together. She really does. Recently, I became more than aware of people continually making fun of some of the girl artists out there. And you know what I told Minxie? I said, keep doing it. Whatever you're doing, keep doing it. Because when the trolls and the haters come along, you're doing something right. You're doing something right. That's when you got to turn on the coal. Start shoveling that coal into the furnace. Get that fire stoked up. You're doing something right. And that's advice to all of you out there. I know there's a lot of young artists that... there was that one young lady. Sugar and Spice ASMR. Everybody thought she did like some blackface thing with Laura. It was not... I've had some people say that's not blackface. Whatever. I'm not going to argue that. I will tell you, you're doing something right. You're pushing buttons. You're getting noticed. You made a mistake. You learn from it. And you keep going. That's when you start becoming an artist. There's the content creator, which I do not consider myself a content creator. I am a videographer. I am somebody who works with video. I work with all stages of video. I'm not just a content creator cranking out crap. I'm constantly doing stuff with my video cameras in and outside of YouTube. I am a videographer. But there's content creators, and then there's artists. And if you want to become an artist, you have to make people think. You have to get a reaction. You have to shock people a little bit. And I know I don't get along with all my fellow artists. So I've heard. But that should tell you that we're pushing things. We're trying to shock, wake people up. Get people to think. Get people to make decisions. Now, they don't always agree with you, and they don't always have the same opinion as you once you wake them up and shock them. But the idea is you're putting it out there. You're putting your heart out there. So you can't be afraid when you've done that. If the reaction is negative, and you can't be afraid not to do it because you're afraid of the reaction. You just do it. You just do it, and to hell with it. And I think people that know me, really know me, know there's no stop button on this ride. There's no brake. That's not always a good thing, but I digress. So I was telling everybody how great Minxie was. She's the comeback kid, if you ask me. She is the comeback kid. You knock her down. KO, knock her out. In the ninth round, and she's right back in the next fight. Right back in the next fight, throwing punches. There's no quit in that girl. And I was happy to see that collaboration with that young couple because I thought it was very thoughtful and very interesting and very ingenious. And I'd like to see more things like that from Laura and from others. And I think this young couple might have something with the whole news thing. I kind of like that. They might be starting to find their little niche, if you want to say that, to make them a little different. So, I know who they are, so I'll put their link down below to help promote them a little bit. So, and back to this lucid dream I had. So, I went out and got sushi last night, and, I usually just get sushi, and then I get a little bit of, salad to go with it, you know, because I'm trying to lose weight, you know, keep my slim swimmer's body looking good, you know. Right. And tingles, somewhere. Do you guys like these things? I took away the background and I'm showing you this cute little fiber optic toy. This one's clear, but it looks kind of blue on camera. The background is by my little girl. She's 13. And I, of course, I'm her daddy. Think she's an extremely talented little lady. Yes, she took art classes, so she's not just some... What do you call that? She's not a, you know, self-made artist. She's taken some very nice art classes that she learned a lot from some very interesting art teachers. Her art teacher at school just, adores her. He's a wonderful teacher. I'm so happy that my school district has a great teacher like him. And he is, well, without saying too much, we have a little bit of history with this teacher. I knew his spouse, and his spouse was an exceptional teacher as well. Now retired, and I just love them to death. They are a gift to the community, and definitely to the students. And I'm very fortunate my daughter's a role model like this in her life. It almost looks like it's alive sometimes. So I'm sitting there, and like I said, I only usually eat the sushi and a little bit of salad, and I decided, well, I'm going to get some of that, hibachi grill. So I got a little bit of hibachi grill, and it was really good. I didn't get a lot. I got a very, very, very small portion. But I had it after my salad, and I'm not sure if there was a ginger mixing with it or what, but it just did not agree with my stomach. I felt very bloated. I just felt lousy. So we had some errands to run after dinner, so we did that. I felt even worse. I didn't eat anything else the rest of the evening, which was good. We ate dinner really early. So by evening, I was a little bit hungry, so I ate a really tiny snack, and I decided to go to bed. I didn't decide to go to bed. I was out. 11:30 at night, I'm out. And around 4:30 in the morning, I work shift work. I work different hours than normal people. This is my day off. I was wide awake at 4:30 in the morning going, oh, good God, I don't want to stay up. I want to go back to bed. So I come out and checked everything in the house. And I went back to bed. Now, from 5, and my wife and my daughter got up, and I slept right through it. I was out. They didn't wake me up. From 5 to 8, I slept some more. So I had a really light, pretty long sleep. I should have been really rested. But instead, I was like, I woke up exhausted. And I woke up to a lucid dream. Now, here's the weird part. I'm not saying you were there, but you were there. The dream was very lucid, and it consisted of one person after another talking to me, just talking and talking, and I couldn't understand anything anyone was saying. It was like a dream within a dream. I knew I was dreaming, and I knew I was dreaming about people I didn't know. I didn't know them. And they just kept asking me questions and saying things, and I couldn't understand them. I couldn't hear them. It's like I could hear that there was words coming out of their mouth, but nothing was comprehensible. I can't put words on it. It was the weirdest, most strange dream I've had in ages, and it was upsetting. I think the reason it was upsetting was I do like to communicate with people and be clear, and I could not understand anything. It was like there was no noise, there was no talking, there was no language, there was just this, I don't know, this numbness, this barrier between us, like a thick piece of plexiglass preventing me from hearing even the most subtle of sounds from the person on the other side. Even reviewing the dream in my mind, I can't tell you for the life of me if I was the one in the glass or they were. I can't tell you because I don't know. I just don't know. I do think about this quite often is responsibility. I think I owe you out there a good time. You deserve a decent video once in a while. And I think I was troubled. I don't know. I think I was troubled because the responsibility of everybody's pain, their life situations, these things weigh heavily on me. We have a responsibility to do right. And I do think we're all connected. You can call it a hive mind or a group consciousness. I don't care. I really don't care. I don't care what you call it. But I do think we're all connected. And I almost know we are. Because I'll be sitting there. Out of the blue, thinking about doing a video. And then I'll turn on my computer to get ready. And I'll see the exact, I'm talking down to the way I was going to frame the shot, the content, everything. I'll see the exact video. I was going to shoot. Done on my list. My subscription list. By another artist. And I'm talking subject matter. Angle of shot. Everything. And I think. That's weird. Now. If I tell you that it's just a bunch of bull crap. It's a bunch of new wave. New age. My experience, and I can't prove it, but it's there. I see it, and I see we're all connected. We get the same people telling us to do the same videos, people wanting us to do the same ideas. And sooner or later, we cross paths. Now, is that hive conscious mind? Is that the group exerting its influence over the individual? You know, is it some metaphysical thing, or is it just random and chance because everybody's talking to the same people about the same things. So our brains start going on the same paths. And sometimes those paths converge and we do the exact same thing. It's probably more than likely. But it's still intriguing. It's still so shocking. And to be honest, it's cool. If somebody does something that I wanted to do before me, most times I go, oh, wow, well, I'm on the right track. And usually I think they did it better. So that's good. So I don't worry about it too much. Plus, if that was the idea and they did it exactly the same, I should go back to the drawing board and be more creative. I should put a little more effort into my idea. I should endeavor, as an artist, to make a better idea, better story, a more interesting video, right? Because in the end, as we've said before, I kind of owe you that. It's my responsibility. I do owe you that. If I could do better, I should. I most certainly should. Do you like these lights? Do they give you the tingles, 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 tingles? That doesn't do anything for me, I'll be honest. But I do think it's kind of cool. Minxie has her little trademark. It's kind of cool. She's a tough girl. Really proud of her as a friend. I do talk about her in some of my videos. I'm really proud of her. She knows that. She knows. Because I don't hold back. I tell her how proud I am of her a lot. At least I think I do. And if I don't, I'm saying it right now. So you can clip this little video out. I'm proud of my friend. Laura Minx. 1, 2, 3. I keep bugging her to come to New York. Visit. She would love it. Her and her boyfriend Nathan. He's a public figure, so I don't mind mentioning his name. He seems like a really great guy. I know that Nathan needs to get her on that flight. Bring her to New York. Because I know she'd love it. And I always tell her the same thing. When you get here, we wouldn't be able to tie you down. You'd be running everywhere. You'd have to keep up with her, not her keep up with us. That's cool. What a great girl. Okay. I love these candies. I can't wait to choke on one. You there? Is that you there? You there? Out there. It was so amazing to have a dream with literally hundreds of people just walking by. Hundreds of people just in my dream. Oh, it was so cool. I loved it. I absolutely loved it. You were all different. Men, women, young, old. You were very expressive. And it was very interesting to touch base with all of you. To hear your voices. consciousness, your mind, your soul reaching out across the vast distances between us to express your thoughts, to express your dreams, to express your lives to me, to make yourself known, to make yourself visible. It was a strange night to get some rest. Sleep was pulling on me hard, pulling me down, pulling my conscious mind down into a slumber. And I used that time to spend it with you, all of you. That's right. All of you out there. I hope you like what I'm doing. I hope you're getting some rest. I hope you're falling asleep. I bet you are. It's so nice to see you today. It is. I'm looking right at you in the camera. And it's so nice to see you today. And I'm so grateful to have you in my life. Busy day. Do you have a busy day? Are you going to try and share a little love and comfort and peace with someone in your life today? Can you do that for me? Do you think so? Even if it's just walking your dog. Try to share a little love in your life today. If we can't dream of a better life, how could we imagine or create a world that is a better life? So don't give up on those dreams. Don't give up on yourself. It's out there. We can do it together. One video, one moment, one good night's restful sleep, leading to the next, to the next, to the next, to the next, to the next. I want you to find some peace today and some comfort. And know that I'm here. I'm here. If you need to reach out, I'm here. I'll listen. I'm not the smartest guy, but I will listen. I'm smart enough to listen. like this video, let me know and I'll do more like it. Maybe a longer version. Or I could put this on like a loop so you can have it over and over again. Let me know what you think. And until we see each other again, please look at the links below. Try to be supportive of other artists struggling to get noticed. I'm sure most of you already know Laura, but if you don't, please give her a look. Give her a sub and a comment. She's a very, very genuinely nice lady. And I'll leave you with all that. Thank you for joining me today. Until I see you all again, may you have a most wonderful day.